So good morning, everybody, and happy Dasara, and have a wonderful festival time. Thanks to one or two people has called me specially on talking about why don't you take a session on how to be a debt-free. I have been doing this almost like 2 years, my webinars every Saturday, but I have not done this seminar on this topic. So I always love when the new topic comes because it made me to read quite a lot, made me to think and how I can project. And whenever I start doing this kind of webinars, and that's the one fundamental, as Robert sir has told, that I normally do webinar only what I do first and then teach. I never do any webinar where I have not applied myself. So when I was speaking with Anil, he says, do you have a presentation ready? I said, no, actually, my presentation is not even ready. But I have tons of stories I know in my mind what I have to tell them, because that is what is coming in my mind. And that stories actually make the differentiator in my any of my presentation. And Robert says, my presentation may be the same, but not even one single stories will be the same, because every time I try to give you the real stories, and my intention is very clear. Life is short, not to invent everything yourself. Somebody has experiences, learn from their experience and go on. And that's what today I'm just trying to tell you. Different people have come. I have total, when I was writing in my notepad, the stories, it meant more than 25 stories. I'm assuming if the time permits, I may try to tell as many stories I can in this webinar. So I have made as very simple. Intention is very clear, how not to have so much of debt. And that is my thought of, I'm trying to tell, the reason I was talking to my all the customer, and I said, I know that you don't need it, but please move it on to the next generation, because that's where I have a fear of a next generation. And that's what I wanted all of you, if you have been knowing somebody, please pass it on this video or recording anytime, to make sure that they are happy, because investments are actually a emotional game. It's not the number game. And when we are in a debt, we are not having a peaceful mind. We don't have a peaceful sleep. And that's where we all the health issues and other things keeps going on and on. So today's topic starts on how to be debt-free for a life. This is the Right FinTalk series and from the Right Horizons. Main purpose is always our tagline talks about guiding you to achieving your financial goals. And that's where our thoughts. So I'll start with today's agenda, which talks about debt management, 5 steps in a debt management, how to be happy and peaceful. My when I was talking about my mentor and my coach, and that's a very common thing. Anybody, when you go, they say, what is your why? And then they keep driving you from your past history and everything. And then you write 5 sentences, 5 pages. Then you go back to the 5 words. And then it comes to the 1 word. And my 1 word game is only that it's called helping. And then they convert it into inspire. So my purpose of my life itself is to how to help other or how to inspire, that they will be also having the same peaceful life. I'm not saying that you should have $1 million, $1 billion. But whatever you have, you're very happy. And that's where my thought and process is. So I wanted a first poll to come. Smriti, can you run the poll, please? Which talks about living in a debt-free. It's realistic aspiration or utopia? So please enter your thoughts. So we have got 50%. We'll have 30 more seconds to do ahead. So maybe I felt I have not clear. Actually, my English is always very bad. So I was just thinking I should write utopia versus realistic or what. So let us close and just show the results, Smriti. So the result shows that, yes, it's a realistic aspiration, 21%, which is 90% of the people are saying. 2%, I'm assuming they're saying it's utopia. If not, I still means that, yes, it is a very, very realistic. If we are a realistic goals, we have it. So I like to have the second poll also. Can we run the poll, Smriti? So please enter the Second poll, this is multiple choice. You can enter many more things which you have. And it's always nice to see when things are always going on the right side, where I can see the maximum people are saying they have no nodes. So I am assuming they are come here to spread the good things to the others also, because this topic may not be as good. So we'll have a 30 more seconds. Around 75% people have participated. So we can show the results, which says that 38% both home loans and the no loans, which is a good sign. And very rarely, which I have seen, 21% is for a personal, 4 is hand loan, and outstanding is 13%. So thank you for participating, and this gives me a good thing. So I feel our people who are coming here are well aware of the how the debt market works. So this is the, I can think of, I'm sure all of you must have seen this. If you can just let me know what is the, comes in your mind when you think of financial crisis. Anybody can tell?
Yeah, of course, losing all the money, losing all your money in banks.
Thank you, Umesh. Anybody else?
Equity crashing very badly and everybody in the red.
Yes, yes. Thank you, Robert. The best part I remember, because I quit Infosys in 2008 itself, and I joined Right Horizons that time. So not only that, it is the time, the whenever there is a market crash, you can say 92, 2000 and 2008. 2008 was the highest crash, which is minus 67%. So this was the biggest crash. You can say it's a financial crash, Lehman Brothers crashes, you can say anything. But for me, it was a simple word which tells it, it is a prime where people have taken loans more than what they can repay. It was as simple as that. So I'm talking about a crisis which has happened in the market. I'm going to talk few instances like this, where it is not necessary, it's a personal dependent. It is a bigger things also. So why these things happen? Because that's a, one of the things which is always irritating in my mind, how to make sure the youngster doesn't go into the same crisis in India, because I can foresee this coming very soon in India also. Because now there's a lot of customers, kids, I go to the Christ College for the wealth management course when I speak with them. And there is what I felt it, we have seen not so much of luxury from our parents and the money. So we have saved quite a lot. But our kids, it looks like they have born with a silver spoon, and the importance of money has not come. So I was speaking on my wealth management course in one of this Christ College, and they asked me, how's the market, how to make quick money? That's a normal question all kids comes and ask. Then I was asking that, why you are not joining as a campus? And that person gave me a very simple answer. Ma'am, my pocket money is only 50 and the campus is giving me less. Why the hell I should do job? And I was very surprised. I said, I should speak to your dad, not to yourself. So sometimes we ourselves are not talking about, we spend much more than what we have. And we always try to have that kind of luxury. And that's where sometimes this crisis comes, because we got used to of that lifestyle. And the changing a lifestyle is a very, very different game. So this is 2008. So I'm talking about very, very fresh things in 2021, which is not even 1 month old. Anybody can tell about this? I keep getting every single time this queries. Anybody can tell? This is another similar things which I can talk about it. It tells about, in China also, they say it's a bubble, this may happen. Again, the same old story, that people have taken loans much, much more than what they can pay. It's about, again, bank who will take care of those. Is it the government or it's the people? People's money has gone. So the thing is always same. How we can take care, if you're talking about country level, you're talking about market level or an individual. This person, I'm sure, always been known of very flamboyant boy. He's having so rich. He's having so many cars. He's having the best of airplanes and everything. But what happened? His also is the same story. He has around 6,000 crore plus as an debt. Even his personal everything is got seized and everything he was not able to repay. So these are the some of the common names I am taking where you can easily relate. It is not that only the people who are earning less or the people who are not able to do have the debt issues. The debt issues are much bigger in million and billion when you see the bigger picture. But we have to learn from them. We don't have to go to the same crisis. The things comes in my mind, and when he died, I keep asking Anil why he did that. I'm sure you must have remembered that CCD Siddharth, and he committed suicide. And his, if I'm not wrong, his net worth was still 3,000 crore, and he was a debt of 1,200 crores. And I keep asking Anil, is it why the hell he quit, or what made him to so much of stress that he did this committed suicide? Okay. So sometimes I have seen much, much bigger, and which made me to keep thinking these kind of questions. I don't know how much we take learning from them and how much we can do, but my today's thought is take small thinking from them. We don't want those kind of 1,000 crore, 5,000 crores kind of debt and other issues, but how in our limit we can take care of ourselves. So there are facts and trends which is happening. I wanted to be taken care of. Most of the time, I remembered my mother used to tell, I'm from North, she'll say that, utna hi pair pasara jitna chadar hai. So you should be in your means. If you're not having so much earning, don't spend more than what you can. But nowadays, the trend has gone other side. This is, yeah, it's very easy to take. Why don't I do? My friend is having this, this is having. So this is another trend which I have seen, because ease of taking a debt is also is a, one of the reason I felt it. Even you can manage it, but still they take it. So why people take loan? So that's another thought we always say is, of course, to maintain living, to buy a house, car, buy a digital gadgets, not only digital gadgets, eating out, you have the taking care of monthly expenditure, status and image building is becoming another thing I felt it. This is the, I'll give you a simple example. Only 2-3 days back, there is a person who came to me and she said, I want some money. And I said, why you need the money? Saying, no, actually I need the money because festival season, there's so much of sale and I need to buy. And I said, it doesn't need, if because it is a sale, you need to buy. No, the same clothes and same things was much costlier when I wanted to buy, but now it is sale, so I should do. So I said, there is no point in buying the things which you don't have money, and then to, because it is in a sale. So that is the another thing I was, even though I denied to give the loan, I'm sure she must have gone somewhere else or taken a hand loan or borrowed from family, friend or anything. But it is very surprisingly, a lot of times, especially people in festival time, the loans time, are getting a much, much more on either because my all friends are having good whatever dresses or something, and I wanted to buy. So this is another person who came to me and said that I want a lakh of loan. So I asked, why you need a lakh of loan? No, it is one of our relatives' wedding. Then I said, it's a relative's wedding, not yours. And why you need a loan? No, because for a wedding, we need to spend money for the clothing. And I was telling, you have 1,000 clothes, you go and take one of those, nobody's bothered. No, ma'am, we can't repeat the clothes in the wedding. And that made me to think quite a lot. Is it so? Because I normally repeat every day and every time, because I'm the one person who don't believe it in those. So I have always 30 clothes as a count. I never go above 30. So if I buy something, I give it off. But I was just thinking, these are the things sometimes our lifestyle thinking, our way of image, what people believes and think, it has to change. If not, sometime we will go into the issues of a debt. So whenever you are thinking of a loan, of course, some loans are good, which I'm going to take it in a future next time, like it's giving you tax benefit. It is. I'm not going to add a lot more in this presentation on business loan side, but yes, sometimes their business loan also gives a quite a good benefit. But this time I'm taking a personal how to be a debt management. So why when we have a different thoughts people needs, what type of loans people have. So you have a lot of loans nowadays coming on payday. This is the another things, personal loan, cash advances. I'm sure a lot of time people are giving a cashes, credit card, auto, home. So most of the time I have seen auto and home and student loans are the three things which is a good side part of a loans. Mortgage, debt consolidation, business loans. These are the different types of loans which normally people take care of it. So these are the things which I have just got it, how the things has changed. So I have we have a morning walk people, and then he was trying to say that previously like a factoring, discounting and other things was not taken as a even legal. Nowadays it's so common. There's a one young person came and he is having only the third salary coming, and he's explaining me how he has a multiple credit cards and he do the payment of rolling of credit cards. And I was very surprised because I never had a second credit card, and first credit card is also like a supplementary of earnings. So it is easier for manage, and I never pay any credit card which I know I cannot pay in the next installment. So some things we have to see. So he's saying, no, it's so easy. You can just take care of a one credit card, roll it to other. My salary just get over by 20th. So I go to, there are so many apps which give me salary in advance. And by first I take care and then I keep rolling across. So I was telling this circle of your 20th, taking a salary, paying for 10 days interest never ends. He said, that's the way it works. And that is another thought process I wanted to give it to all of you. This is not a salary advance or the things. It is a habit. If you have a habit of keep asking and looping across, this always keeps going on and on and on. And this reminds me when we were in college, we will ask our friend, can you give me? And then it will be 5-10 rupees. Now I don't know, the rates are also gone high in the colleges. So if I ask somebody, okay, you owe me a 500, 5 rupees, can you give me? That person will ask third, fourth, fifth, and it comes back to you. So it's like a round robin and come back. And then you said, okay, I don't need the money because it has come back to me. So most of the time, we used to ask things which you know how you can pay back. But digital lending is becoming a very, very big thing. So I don't want to name for a few fintech because I know personally. And I said, what is your revenue model? He says, no, I have to just increase the number of active participation. And the next biggest thing in the next 10 years is just lending. And we will earn money only on interest. So it is okay when you are in a need, but don't do it because it is easier. So there is a one person came and I asked him why you have taken. He says, no, it is on mobile. They said, if you want, you take for 10 days and then you can repay. And I said, you didn't pay in 10 days back. So what happened? It's okay, I will do it again. So ease of ability of lending, digital lending, you can say P2P lending, is making also a worse part of it. So be aware. So anything, nothing comes free in this world. That's the one thing I wanted to tell you. Everything have his own part of it. So most of the time, please make sure that, 1 minute. So please make sure that you take the money when it is must. It's not necessary. This is I'm trying to do with the age group. And if you see that below 35, it's almost 66% has people has registered in P2P lending. I was not even aware even few months back that there was a P2P lending people do and they make sure. So I thought it is like a normally Marwari and other people keep doing a lending and that's what it is. They said, no, it is so common that you can go to the P2P lending and do it. Only good, bad part of it, it is always make sure that it is, they see the CIBIL reports, they see the, your. That's another thing I have learned recently P2P lending people do is they check your social media and other groups also. Previously, it was only CIBIL reports and the ratings. So make sure that you don't go into a trap of a lending because it is ease of getting money. what is the debt? Debt is actually just somebody, you are money you owe. Your obligation is there because somebody has given you the money. It is like a, you can say, home loan, you have taken a credit card, or you have taken a, any of the money. So you are owning that money, and then you are able to taking care of that. So debt management is a practice of keeping debt under control and monitoring the spending of the debt accurately. You should not be overwhelmed with, especially when you are taking a debt. This is one thing where I remembered when I was 2001, we took the first house, and my mom and dad says, we have never taken the house till we have the full, why you're taking a loan? And I said, no, we are getting a good loan with a good tax benefit, and that's why I did it. So this is my first and last learning of my debt side issue also. We both know each other quite well, and we married early and earning quite good, both of them in IT itself. So we said, okay, because you're getting the tax benefit on a home loan. So we took two houses on each name. And then after 4 years, when we got the first kid, we were not able to manage because I wanted to take more leaves than a maternity 3 months leave. And then what happens, and I asked for them and they said, you cannot extend the maternity leave and I have to leave my kid and go abroad and work. And that's the one thing I keep telling all the girls, at least, please make sure if both are also working, don't take two EMIs into salaries. Maximum, you should take only one, because one person cannot pay two EMIs and run the house. So that is the one on long-term learning. I always felt it, that I will be not able to spend time with my kid because we have a two EMIs. The time I came back, we sold the house and I said, I will never buy the second house. Till date, we feel that it is not easy for us to have. It's not because of EMI or something, but we wanted to be very clear that, okay, we don't want it to run on the behind debts or the real estate kind of it. So most of the time, don't ever go your money EMI above the 40%. That's another learning. I always feel we should always think about it. So I'm going to talk about the 5 steps in the debt management. There's a very simple step. I'm sure if you go back to your parents, they must have done this wonderfully well. We only has mix and matches, and we have said, okay, this is a little bit of lifestyle, a little bit of ease, and a little bit of, I can say, we can manage kind of risk-taking perspective. And that's where we have some issues. So I start with the prepare your list. So most of the time when we do financial planning, I normally ask, how much is your debt? And you will be surprised to know most of the people, they really don't know what is the outstanding debt they have. Okay. So that is the first point we try to say. So before I go, I'll have the poll 3. Yeah, Smriti, can you close it and show? So it is nice to see that 50% of the people have less than 20% and 33%. So which is a very, very safe side. As long as you are less than 40, you don't have to worry. You can easily manage it. Another 5 people, which is 17 people, we should look at the how we can reduce those part of it. So what are the different ways we can say how to prepare? That's the first and foremost, I always say, we should look at. So what are the things we can do? List the loan. That's the first and foremost, please do that. What are the type of loans you have? You have hand loan, car loan, home loan, personal, credit card, P2B, advance from your family, friends, anybody. Please do that part of it. Then write who is the owner, because most of the time it can be you, it can be joint. If it is a partner in the company, you can write now, but even though I'm not going to take that part of it, amount of loan. That, like, if for example, you have started it 1 crore, what is the interest rate that time and the now? How many months you have paid and how much is the outstanding? Do they have any tax benefits? Because for example, home loan may have a tax benefit. Education loan have a tax benefit. Of course, company also do have. So you have to write what are the benefits, what is the outstanding and duration is left. Very, very important, because most of the time when I sit and try to help people on taking care of debt consolidation and other things, these data help us quite a lot. So this is the another things you should make sure that we always do that part of it. If you don't have it today evening, please make sure you do this. Because yesterday night I was doing one financial planning, and that person have 4 crore of home loan. And I asked that because that question keeps coming, which is a very common question. Do I need to pay the home loan now, or I should continue, because they had a home loan saver account. And then I asked that, what is your rate of interest in there? And this is, I really don't know. And I was thinking, 4 crore loan, and somebody doesn't know the interest rates. It's, for me, it is, maybe I'm used to this kind of question, but then I realized, yes, we should make sure, because sometimes we are not even aware. Then I told them, home loans are the all-time low now. If you have more than even 6.7, please reduce your loan. And I told them today they're supposed to go and find it out and reduce it. So first thing I always say is, you should know what is the interest rates now and what is the duration left. The reason is, some of the duration, like a car loan or any other loan, when it is left last 1 year or 2 years, what will happen? Only principal part is left. So paying it just that time also doesn't make sense, because you have already paid all the interest. So these questions are very, very important when you are taking care of your debt. So please make sure today, if you have even one single loan, even a home loan also, keep these data ready. Even if you are managing yourself, that how much is the home loan? If home loan is more than 6.7, please go back and check it. They will just charge you around 5 to 10K to reduce it, instead of just transferring to the another. If they are not doing it, please transfer. Because some of the banks, they say, no, we do only for the new loans, not for the old. They just wanted to retain. But if you tell them that I'm transferring it, they will 100% reduce your rates. Second part of it. The second part is, talks about how to prioritize. Okay. When you're prioritizing your debts, most of the time, whenever you're prioritizing, the above data is very, very important. Is it this loan is for a long term, short term? How it's taking care of my day-to-day household things? It's taking care of tax benefit or not, the interest rates or not? What are the facilities I am going to do? Things which is not at all linked to the, I can say, the growth part of it. Most of the time when I speak, it's people says my credit cards bills are been outstanding. So most of the time you don't know, if you have a credit card bill of 10,000, even if you pay 9,000, you pay the interest for full 10. They don't take for the 9 until unless you pay the full, the interest is taken on full amount. Second thing is, it is very, very high. Third thing is, in case if you have changed into the installment base, that installment, even you do prepayment also, it's very high. So these are the things which are very, very high interest rates. It's between 12 to 16%. I know a person who came to me last month or last 3 weeks back. He's just 25 years old, and he told me, Auntie, I just wanted to do the financial planning. And I said, fine. And when I sit sometime with the youngster, it's so nice that they are planning. And then I said, what I can help you? So he says, no, I am doing some business. I am trying to start my own. And I said, yes. So first thing you will ask, what is your, normally it's like a, we say cash flow. Cash flow is like how much you're earning, how much you're spending, and then how much is your debt? These are the normal questions we ask before you can think of even investments. So I ask, okay, how much is your debt? So I'm surprised to say, so he said around 30, 35 lakhs. And I said, what, 35 lakhs? At the age of 25, what you did? So he says, no, I like bike riding. So I took 8 lakhs bike. Then I like car. So he took 20 lakhs car. Then third, he took it across because he wanted to do go some rally. So he took some money in that. So total, it's become like a 30 lakhs. And I was very surprised. 30 lakhs, and when you don't have any steady income, how a person can pay for it? Forget it that I'm trying to help somebody to get it. Of course, he claims that he's going to get a good in a business, and I'm hoping that he'll be able to do. But this reminds me the question when I was attending one session in Wipro, maybe in 98 or 99, then some of the trainer was telling me, when you are young, no, you wanted to like to put a, I remember my son also keeps saying that I want a Lamborghini car and all. And he used to tease me that you don't know how to pronounce Lamborghini also. And he said, this is 4 crore, 5 crore car. And I said, where is in India you will have this car? Because it doesn't go, there's no place, no good road. He says, no, they are the best car. Now from last 5 years, he says, no, now it's a Tesla is the best car. Okay. Now I was telling him, then when the reality comes, you may take it a secondhand car also. Okay. So the reality versus the what your imagination, you have to be yourself. You cannot go when you know that you cannot make sure that you can pay 4 crore or maybe 1 crore. It's nothing wrong to have a secondhand car, or nothing wrong if you are going for biking to rent a car bike. It means that you should know a different alternative without changing your lifestyle, how I can do the best. Okay, this is what I personally like to tell in the prioritization. I always tell people not to change much lifestyle, just fine tune little, which will not going to impact much. Like a salary advance, once or twice somebody can take. When you are taking a regularly, means you have gone to the trap, means you are not doing the proper budgeting, planning or whatever. So this is the second point which I wanted to enforce. Live within your means, not by the status, not because somebody is assuming. This is the another things which I was reading. I'll show you in the next few slides, which talks about don't judge the book by the cover, because you don't know. And that's my assumption. When I was also in college, I used to tell Anil that, oh, that person is so nice with the western dress and pencil heel. I was so fascinated with the girls coming in a pencil heel, because I never wear pencil heel. So I said, oh, they are so well to do and all this stuff. And I came to know few people, and I realized that they actually don't have a money. And I was telling, my God, I used to think that they are so well to do because they are dressing so well. So sometimes it's a people do quite a lot with the status. This is last few COVID time. I remember not only this is a few celebrities has mentioned in all those trending news I was getting that, if the COVID doesn't come up, that I don't have a money in my bank, or their EMIs is 5 to 7 lakhs, because they have gone by their status that they should have so much of luxury or whatever it may be. So my thought is, even if it's a celebrity or not celebrity, by nature, you should spend only what you can. Don't go what people perceive. Don't go what people think about it, but go what make you happy. And it makes sure that you have a proper sleep without stressful. The another third point, very important, is repay the higher interest rates. So when we, our first point was making the list of what are the interest rates, okay? So those are the things which we have to try to repay. So whenever repayment comes, it's a very good, we do pros and cons that, okay, if I'm not a repaying, at the same amount, if I'm investing something, how we call word arbitrage. For example, for a home loan, I always say now, you may not have to pay because you are getting at 6.5. And the same amount, if I add it across for 5 years, on a basic balance fund also, I will get 9 to 10%. So I'm still getting 3% higher. So why don't you do? Because you're getting their tax benefit also, and it's the lowest. So most of the time, whenever you are thinking, you have to look at either you are doing any repayment, which is the highest rate. If there are tax benefits, you can think after tax benefit, what are the things happening? Do they have a pre-closure charges or not? That's another thing, partial, full, and FI. When we buy the loans, I think so none of us, including me, never see that 40 page, what are the terms and conditions. We just sign it and we are bothered to the money comes in mind. But when we start going for a closure, then they say, oh, you didn't see that there's a terms and conditions says that there's a pre-closure charges 3%, or you have to give 10,000 bucks or something. Those are the things when slowly, slowly terms and conditions start coming across. Tenure is very important when you started thinking of repayment. EMI reduction versus tenure. This is the another thing. When we are reducing, they can ask you the two questions. That do you want to reduce a tenure? It means that your EMI continues the same, but 15 years loan will become 12 years or 11 years. Or you can reduce the EMI and the tenure is the same. So you have to decide what you are looking at. Maybe sometimes I normally do the analysis both the ways, that instead of reduction of tenure or the amount, if you are reducing the EMI and investing in SIP, what can be the best part of it? How to repay? Start small. Don't have to think so big and okay, when I get my bonus, then I'll do. And the bonus didn't come, it never happens. Or I will say that, okay, I will repay next time when I get a promotion. So most of the time they start. You can think of a smaller things. Maybe you can start, increase your EMI, maybe 5K, 2K, because that certainly goes from your principal. Do part payment whenever the additional monies has been come. I remembered in a Wipro, we used to have a quarterly payouts, half yearly and yearly. And any one of times we never use those, because in our budgeting system, we used to have only monthly. So that amount we will just suddenly goes and put it in investments anyway. So similarly, in case you have the loans, you should be able to do that part of it. Avail loan if they have EMI waivers or interest-free loans. Some of the companies, they do give interest-free. Try for that. Maybe sometimes it is good, even though I don't recommend more, but it is good sometimes to take a loan, very small amount from a PF or something when it is a very, very urgent, because you can give back. Because PF and all, it's, I still feel it's a very good things linked to retirement, 8.5 tax-free. But it is still better than 14-15% giving. But what I have noticed, and that's the reason I don't tell people to do it, is they take it from PF, but they never return it back. They said, it is my money, I got it. But you're not realizing that you're losing, which is actually has been given by the government as a subsidy. 8.5 tax-free is amazing returns. Negotiate on interest rates. It's okay your bank is not allowing it. There are many other banks are allowed to do it. So it's okay if you just go and tell them, if you're not returning, I am just going to the next bank. Everybody will try to do that. Make sure that you will have it. Take one debt at a time and close it. Highest loan, try to have a timeline and do it. Most of the time, that is the best way to focus and close it. This is the another best learning I always feel people. When we ask anyone, when I go for the youngsters and all, they say, ma'am, I don't have a money only. So this is the very standard answer I get it, that we don't have a money. And my belief is money is never be a reason for investments. Actually, it's normally discipline. If you have a discipline, it works wonder. And discipline can start with just $500, not from $5,000, $10,000 also. So just start first. So most of us, what we do, we get our income or salary, pay EMI bill, spend. And in case if it is left over, it is actually go for investment. But the actual thing is, first we should make sure that 25% minimum of your take home should go for a save and invest. Then you pay the bills and EMI and then spend. So that is a better way of doing it. And I can tell you, because I'm doing more minimum 25 plus, and that compounding effect works wonders. Just before the session, one of my customer was telling I should do this or take it out. He's just started SIP maybe a few months back. Can I stop it and do it? I said, when the market is up, everybody is fund manager. And I feel too many cooks always spoil the food. So either you run it or I should run it. So most of the time, you should make sure when you are in a discipline, taking an average, continue it. And you will get the compounding effect very, very good. Plan, follow, repeat. My all-time favorite. That's what I normally do with a lot of session also, talking about how to make sure that do financial planning or follow and repeat. This I have been doing. This is my 26 years of my working. And I have been doing for 26 years. Of course, because Anil takes care of all, so I get 100% investment for myself. But I am trying to say, plan. That is very, very important. Most of us, we don't budget and plan. I keep telling, all of us must have done, and I'm sure if you wanted to buy, even today being a weekend, if you wanted to go and watch a movie, you will do at least, I can bet you, for 15 minutes to see which theater to go, what movies are running, what time it is running, who all will go. And then they will ask what to eat. We are going for lunchtime or dinner time or whatever. For a movie which is not even 1,000 to 2,000 rupees, we spend it 15 to 20 minutes. When we are talking about lifelong savings and we are talking about our goals, why we are not spending that much of budget and planning and expenses? Please do. That's very, very important. That is another thing when we do in financial planning. There is a one sheet called a cash flow where we write about the how much is your income and how much is your expense. When I ask a general question to everybody, how much you spend in a month? So my whatever the answer, let us say 50,000, I normally add 40-50% extra. So they say, why? Then I go, we have a standard question. So we keep asking those questions. And when it goes, no, it's sometimes it's like a double the money what they're spending. Because most of us, we never add our yearly things in a monthly. I'll give you example, especially for all of us whose kids are going to the school. Our school fees itself is coming like a 4 to 5 lakhs. And that comes on a yearly basis. So you need to convert that into the monthly. That all the festivals, the birthdays, the anniversaries, everything we spend on a yearly basis, or we are doing, I normally says, okay, how many people into the anniversary, this many celebrations. We don't convert into the monthly. We have our travels. It can be a small travel or vacation. We don't convert them into the monthly. So most of the time, make this monthly plan also. And then you have to see how much you can take care of it. Especially now when the festival time is going on, a lot of people have been going over budget. So please, I request you all, there is nothing wrong. I keep teasing my mother also that God knows us better than us. You don't have to spend money because of Diwali, I have to buy such a good dress. I said, you can buy even 500 rupees dress also. And that's the one good thing I always tell. It's like expectation setting. So this happens to me, this my birthday 2 months back. I came to office and somebody says, why you didn't wear the good new dress? And I said, no, actually, I purchased the material. I didn't give for the tailoring and then didn't come. So that's the reason. And especially back to the square one, because you are plus size, you don't get a good thing. So I didn't give it. And he's saying, no, if I was in your place, I must have gone in midnight and got the new dress. And I was telling Anil, I never felt any bad that I'm not wearing a new dress. But all people around me was coming and telling, no, there is something is wrong because you're not wearing the good new dress. So forget it. Most of the time, have your own plans. Be happy what you feel. Invest 25%. Don't overgo above 40%. I am sure all of us slowly, I have seen this few. I am just trying to put it across as one of the point, even though it's not a part of it. Smriti, can you mute others, please? Emergency money is to put aside a little bit on a monthly, have it 6 months of your household into the emergency. Last few times we have seen because people not having a medical cover properly, they have also lost a lot of money and borrowed a lot of money. Please, please take a good medical cover. Previously, people 3 to 5 lakhs, people were okay. But now I have been telling that minimum 10 lakhs you should take for your medical cover. Because I have seen people have, means in a family, 3 to 5 people have problem or they got a COVID. And 3 to 5 lakhs was too less because it's a family floater medical cover. So please do that. Of course, medical emergency, I have seen few, which I don't think so it's come under the debt trap kind of it. But yes. If you must have planned in advance, that question must have never come. Cut back your spending. Don't, there is a, I do a webinars for value of money from the kids 7 to 14 and 14 to 19, okay? And that's a one homework kind of I give to them to write a needs versus want, okay? So I keep asking them what is a need and what is a want kind of it. So suddenly I'm realizing even the kids, what's supposed to be like a need and want, they will say, no, that is a mandatory. Like I wanted a computer game. It's a very necessary auntie. And I'm saying without that game also you can live. It's okay. You can go out with a friend and play something else. No. So this is the another definition we have to think in our mind. What is need and the want? This trend has changed last 3 years, which I have also seen not only in the kids, even adults when I'm doing financial planning. Previously, including me, I used to feel vacation is always a want. If you have money, you go for a vacation. Or I'm talking about a larger, longer vacation going abroad with 4 to 6 lakhs a year. But now that is becoming a mandatory day. I told one of my customers recently, because the vacation is too high, it's impacting retirement. She says, it's okay, Rachna. When we are retired, we don't have a time, money, energy to go. Let us see when retirement comes, how it's impacting us. But let us continue the vacation. So this is comes under lifestyle. Okay. So personally, my intention is to tell you, your thought is this is my need or a want. And I'm not saying somebody is right or somebody is wrong. Everybody is right in their own perspective. I am no one to say somebody's lifestyle, it's right or wrong. You are the best judge and try to find it out to if I am in doing in this lifestyle, can I sustain or not? Rent versus buy. It's a very, very common thing comes for a home, second home. It can be vehicle going for anything. There is nothing wrong to have a rent. When you go abroad, because of my previous job, I have gone more than 48 countries. And I can tell you, this is so common there where people buy seconds. Okay. And here people used to think, now at least trend is changing again. You know, if you're buying a second hand, it is not good. Or it is renting is not good. It's fair enough. So normal question comes in home, I will take a second home, I'll do the rent. And 1 crore house is giving me only 20,000 or 30,000 of the rent. When I take care of your all the maintenance and other real estate person to give the 1 month charges, it's a 10 months rent. It's not even yielding you 2%. And actually the full real estate is also not grown more than 5 to 6%. You realize that last 8 years, actually that if I must have put it in saving banks, it must have given me more. So sometimes we should do these exercise ourselves and make sure to stick to the plan. Most of the time we make a plan very nicely. We start executing, thank God, but we don't want it to stick. We just deviate. We will just say no, because what happens, we keep getting all these noises from around. When you're getting from noise from around, your mind started thinking differently. Okay, this is the another behavior science. I have normally a session, we will give it to you. It's a behavior science kind of it. So this is a story of that ant. I'm sure all of you must have heard that they said all the ants to go to the top of the hill. And everybody was around them. They're saying how they can go. It is so far. They are so small and all. Only one ant reached till top. And then they started asking that ant why that ant only went. Because that ant was a deaf. She never heard the negative things what other was telling. So similarly, when we have a plan, execute it. Don't bother what others are saying. As long as your concepts are clear, nothing happens. I keep telling everybody, please try to stick to the concept. The concept is very clear. Think long term, have discipline investment, you will overcome. Of course, when last but not the least, we're talking about loans and the debt. And some debts are good. Yesterday itself in the night financial planning, they have enough financial assets. They have 4 crore, as I told you, the loan. They don't need to because there is no other dependent person and all. But it is good, I can say recommended, to take a term cover, which is because now that's one of the cheap, till your outstanding. So normally nowadays, because it's the old one, new home loan bankers, they give the term cover also, which is equivalent to your loans. So you make sure that it is being taken care of. So anybody can say this is the last 10 days infographic coming across in the WhatsApp, and which is very, very, and that catch my eyes so much actually. Anybody have seen this? It's normally what we give. So I always say it is looks are deceptive. We spend so much time, money, energy in what our perceiving notion is, what people think about it. And it is, you take it as a Warren Buffet or NRN or a Premji, or you can say Rakesh Jhunjhunwala or anybody. At end, after some time, the money doesn't matter. It is talking about what you are happy with, what you are looking for. So simple living is another way I feel, being a October month of Gandhi's Jayanti, it makes sense that be happy, have simple living. That's another person I want, anybody in this room, if somebody can use this person. And why he's famous now.
Yeah, he's Mr. Vembu.
Yeah. Thank you, Umesh. It's Zoho CEO. He is Sridharan Vembu, and he has moved from US to here in a small village. He's making the head office of Zoho here. He travels only by cycle. He's been giving more than 3,000 people for food, and he's trying to do quite a lot how to bring second tier cities to the better thing. More than that, he's a 59th richest person in the world. Okay. So I am trying to say it's not the olden times people saying, I'm talking, this is actually last 1 week before data. So it depends on what is your why, what is the things which is making you to run, what makes you happy and do that. Doesn't need that I have to show off. If I'm not wearing the suit or something that people think, okay, I'm not rich or something. It doesn't matter if they feel I'm rich or not. Anyway, they are not going to do anything for me. So please be happy what you have. Last fifth part, avoid falling in a trap. Trap is, to me, is I always feel there's nothing wrong in taking loan. As long as you are able to manage the loan, you are less than 40%, you are getting the best of it. Trap is when you're doing again and again and again. That is what it doesn't seems to be okay with me. So I want you to start, because if it is second time happening, I can still say okay. But most of the time when somebody or employees or anybody, even friends, comes and asks me for the loan, personal loan, I mean to say, I normally don't ask what's the reason until they're very close and they tell me. But first time I'll do. Second time I always tell them, can I help you? Why you are doing this? Because the second and third time it become, it's a lifestyle issue. It is their habit issue. They are not a disciplined person. Because of these, so you will be always in a debt for so long. And I can tell you, a debt is a one thing which is, one person I know, he recently, till yesterday, he is in a hospital because of a debt, got the heart attack. Because he's not able to sleep, his mind is not in peace, and he's been thinking of, okay, this person is calling. He's not even keeping the phone because I know somebody will keep calling me. So most of the time, please avoid that. I don't want you to go into that season where you feel that I'm not okay to just be with my family because they will come to my house and do the collection. What may be the reason? Evaluate your lifestyle. You don't need to have a great lifestyle, which is very, very fake. I have been knowing, not because a person, I know that he has been very well to do, but a lot of people have been telling me, Rachna, because it's now working from home is there. I'm gone to my native place, and that person has moved to the Coimbatore, and he says, my expense is 1/3. Okay. So I was telling, it's a very nice thing. I never thought that. And he says that the air is so good and it is so nice, peaceful. And I said, that's really good. So it's not necessary. Sometime, of course, you do for debt, but I'm saying you can evaluate your lifestyle, what you want, how much is your income. You can Have, of course, little bit you can increase, but not necessary. This is the another question I got to know. Another person told me, Rachna, my father started the business and that business didn't do good and we lost all the money. Now they have come to me. So I have to repay their EMI because they don't have it. And I have to pay mine and I'm not able to have that much of money, what I can do. So on those side, it's very difficult for me. And you feel guilty because somebody has come with so much of thought ki you will give the solution. And I always say, I cannot give the solution to all. I can try to help you out. And I said that I'll try to make you to get either a part-time job or your spouse getting the job, which I'll try my best. But more than that, you have to understand how you can try reducing. If you're not able to reduce, please try to do. Credit card usage is another. Don't think it's just a plastic card. You have to pay. It's your own card. So don't keep swiping every time. So this is another friend of mine when we were in college, and they have given, the parents has given, they both were quite well-to-do doctors. They have nursing home their own. And that the mother used to come and tell me, you please take care of Madhuri. And I said, yeah, what happened? Telling no, because whenever she gets angry, she just spend. So I'm very scared. So whenever she gets angry, you'll be there. So I was very surprised that time also. And now I never knew somebody can do that. And she, I still remember, I'm talking about 93, not even now. She went, purchased 2.5 lakh one gold set and came back and told me, I have purchased this, what to do? And I said, I don't know. So she said, no, because I was so angry, I did that. Then we went next day to go and ask that person to return the gold. And that gold person says, no, we can't give in the same rate. So I told that day to her and her mother and everybody, please don't give a credit card. It's okay. She used her cash or whatever it is. And that's a new thing. So I've been, because I do a lot of inductions training now. And I tell all the youngsters, please don't have a credit card. When we don't know how to use the credit cards, it's better not have it. It's better to cut it off, that problem which is creating a problem in future. Please, if you have a credit card, you should know how to use a credit card. Normally, I believe credit card should use to get that mileage. But actually, those people make money only who doesn't pay. But I am not here to make their money working. I'm here to make sure that I am happy. So please pay the credit card which you can pay within your timelines. You have to make sure that buy now, pay later is not a one thing. Make sure that you are committing in your mind, in your thought, and the things will go very properly when you're debt free. Needs and wants, whenever you are asking anything, write it. If I'm not buying that for the next 6 months, is it going to change something? If not, don't buy. Simple as that. Make it increase your income, as I said it, if possible. By part-time, because a lot of time I have seen, I have my niece and my few friends, they started teaching online maths and English, and they charge around 500 to 700 per hour. And she says, I'm easily able to get 8,000 to 10,000 rupees. And I said, that's good. Why don't you invest that only and try to reduce? So it is okay. Even 2 to 3 hours a week is giving you good. There are many, many more options which was not there before. Try to utilize your skills. A lot of time I feel very happy when I see and try to buy from those people who are the old ladies, and the woman has started coming and doing from home, maybe pickle or the masalas or something. At least they're getting a part-time income instead of that all big baskets and other bigger companies. So do that part-time, and you please encourage yourself and others to help them, because at least they are working and then trying to earn more. I always believe it is always nice to help other than keep asking for help. So my dad used to say that he used to always have a hand to give than always asking. So please try to do that. And I can tell you, your mind and yourself will be having a wonderful thought, and you will have a peace of mind with the sleep, which you will never think when you have the actual part of it. So that's all from my side. So I'll have a summary part which talks about follow the CEO model, okay? Which is the method which we call as cut the cost, earn more money, and optimize your spending. This part, as I started with that poll, I keep telling it. Most of the time, if you are below 40, I can say you are in a good limits. You can manage, you can do that, don't have to worry much. If you're going above 50, that is the time you should start thinking how you can come back to 40 and all. And above 50, it is really, really alarm. Please make sure, do this homework for yourself and try how much it can be. Start with a small spending difference. Itself will make a lot of difference. Summary is debt reduction, repay, increase EMI, lower the interest rate. Debt consolidation is the very, very best part. Avoid how much you can take the new debts. This is the new model which we keep call a PIPE. Prepone the investment and postpone the expense and the wants. That's all from my side. I'll be happy to take any questions. So I'm assuming there's no questions. That's like a normally college, no? That everybody understood everything or everybody didn't understand.
Good afternoon. One question I have, like down the line after some years I'll be having some good amount through my mutual fund investments.
Okay.
And meantime, suppose for my daughter's higher education, she wants some money. So actually this amount I am whatever my accumulating it is for my retirement. But for this educational loan, can I go for that?
Yeah, so it's a very good point. Actually, when you're taking an education loan, you don't have to pay. That goes in the kids and the parents become the sponsor. Means they become the backup as a guarantor. So that's fair enough. So at least if they're going, they're also responsible to repay part of it. If they're going abroad, if you know somebody, you can take an education loan from there, which is much more cheaper also. And I always believe that makes at least a kid's very, very, thinking on how to finish their all the course and repay. So more accountability comes when they take the loan. So it is good enough. Let their kids take it and you back it up.
Yeah, thanks Rachna for wonderful answer.
More than that, I will just give you, because this happened when I was in the US also. A lot of time people don't finish their exams because F1 to H1 or an L1 conversion take long time. So it is always good to make sure they will clear that exam and then do it if they have a loans.
Thanks, Rachna.
Can I have the another questions or Smriti, can you read it and then tell me? So I'll just, yes, I'm just going to the chat, which says, Mr. Vivek, can you send the recording? Yes, by Monday, our team will be sending you the recording and the feedback. Please do that part of it. It is education loans, home loans are the good, even of course, business loans, which is giving you the good part of it. It is good to have it. Make sure, I always say, even if you have money, take the education loan, make sure the kids are being accountable for. Unable to pay loans due to income loss. Yes. See, income loss and others are a temporary. I always tell you, you have a multiple things nowadays to do it. I can easily tell you, everyone can go and teach a 5th to 7th standard, even maths and science or whatever subject it is. Or it can be what you like, content writing. We are personally in us working for many 3 to 5 digital media companies. A normal content writer is asking 3 to 5 rupees per word to write in a blog. I know so many youngsters, they purposely, they says, I will become a freelancer because they can write and do it. So I know in some industry, we have faced loans, even income loss, but we have to realize what we are good at and try to do it. If not, please let me know. I'll try my best to make sure that you get the income in some other way. almost all business personal loan take care. COVID fund posting, wonderful. How to get the CIBIL report? It's a very easy. Please go to the CIBIL, write it in a Google CIBIL report, and they charge $400. Some of the banks, they give free of cost. Above 750 is a very, very good score. They get the loans immediately. And below 750 is the reason they may ask to you. Would it possible to get an email copy of slides? Sure. You will be getting the video of the same. And if you want a slide, please write an email. I will put it into PDF and send it to you. Person Mr. John says that I spent 10,000, my wife 50,000. Can you tell the questions? I'm not clear, Mr. John. Aren't there good loans too for home loans? There are many loans which are less than 7% also, yes. Most of our customers' loans are at 6.5 to 6.7. Is it advisable to close loan if it is less than 20% of the total income? As I told you, closing the loan, you have to just see what is the tenure and the principal. It's a mind game of an emotional side. So if it is very low, people do it. But if it is very low, the same thing, if you invest now, it may give you more amount because the loans interest rates are lower. So you should do both the analysis and then go about it.
Rachna, I've got a question to ask.
Yes, please.
The question is that somewhere I was reading that if you have a home loan of 40 lakhs, then if your EMI comes to 25,000 per month or 30,000 for that matter, if you do 25% of that in SIP and both to run simultaneously, then you will pay the loan at a lesser period of time. So before the tenure, is it a right strategy or is the strategy correct?
Yeah, it is. I can do the analysis of both. As I told in one of the slides, if you reduce it, the tenure, whatever amount you have, the buffer, you can start SIPs and it works. Because SIP on an average, we say is around 10 to 12% plus. And this is at 7. So you get it after 5 years, such a lump sum money, and you pay back and close it. That's the way it works. So most of the time, whenever you have a home loan, you try to close when the market you expect to be down. And when you are market expecting to be high and your interest rates are lower, you should not pay for it. So thank you, everybody. It's a nice, wonderful meeting. We will have the next Saturday session on the retirement at the age of 45 or retirement planning. I'll be happy to have you there. Please give your feedback because your feedback makes me to do much more better and try to improve every time. As I know, everybody needs to improvement and I do. Thanks and stay safe and be happy. Enjoy your weekend.